Life is Strange 2, Episode 4, Part 2.
Might be some shade at the next billboard. Yes. Shade. Stop. Oh, man. My feet are killing me. Feels like hiking in hell. Never drew a desert before. Huh. It's so empty and quiet. Okay, just draw now. Don't think about anything else. Got a good picture of it. I'm ready to draw now. This place is so empty. At least I won't mess up perspective for once. I guess that's an okay start. But I can keep going. Okay. Just draw now. Don't think about anything else.
You already said that. Don't have to repeat yourself.
Got a good picture of it. I'm ready to draw now. Guess I could spice things up a bit. Make the whole thing funnier. I could try adding details. Focus a bit more. Okay. Just draw now. Don't think about anything else. Man. My eye always starts hurting when I focus for too long. Throat feels like sand.
Then tell your throat don't feel like sand.
Daniel better be okay. Feels like I haven't seen him in years. Of course I miss everything about him. Even his whining. Yeah, you couldn't wait to get out on your own. Now you are. And it sucks. Jeez. Never been so far south. Oh, shit, there's a truck coming. Whoa. Is he honking at me? He's stopping. Okay, be cool. Just...
be like John Cena.
Truckers can't be cops. Right.
Hey, need a lift? too damn hot to be walking.
Yeah, thanks. Hold up.
I'm American. There's the TP, there's some drinks, there's all that good stuff.
Jeez, what the hell happened to you?
I ran into a couple of assholes. Beat me up for no reason.
I see. Happens a lot around here.
Hey, Anton. You there? Everything all right?
Yeah, what's up?
GPS tells me you parked in the middle of nowhere. Just wanted to know what happened.
I had to make a shit stop. Over.
Too much information, but...
You mean number two?
You owe me a beer for that. Over now.
Don't freak out. I wouldn't have picked you up if I cared about that hitchhiking law.
Okay. Cool.
So, you hungry or what? You look hungry.
This better not be poisonous.
As you heard, my name's Anton. It is
Anton
good,
Banton. Huh?
My wife packs the best sandwiches. Messy.
Best sandwich ever. Seriously. Thanks, sir.
Anton.
Anton. Right.
What's your destination?
Haven Point. You've heard of it?
Oh yeah. Straight ahead, about an hour. Nap if you want. You don't have to stay awake to be nice. Hey, don't worry, kid. I'm not a fucking weirdo. Just a boring trucker.
And we don't get to choose, like I'm just guessing. Go to sleep. Go to sleep, go to sleep, my little shiny.
Last stop, Haven Point.
Thank you so much.
Just be careful out here. These people are kind of weird.
Really? Okay.
10-4, good buddy.
Also, it's at a church. Please don't tell him they're using him as Jesus Christ.
You okay now? Is it gone?
I think.
Good. Scoot back inside now.
Okay, Dad.
Come on, does she have Corona?
Hello there. Is everything all right?
Yeah. Don't worry.
You here for the service?
Yeah. I am, but it's my first time.
Don't be shy. Everybody's welcome here, no matter who you are or where you're from.
Oh my God.
In his eyes, we are all equal. Plus, we have a pretty nice spread after the service. Stay as long as you want.
Okay. Thanks.
Don't thank me. I'm just a vessel for our reverend. Thank her. Looks like you're here to see our new miracle, right?
What miracle?
You haven't heard of him? Then I won't spoil it for you.
He'll yep, they're using Daniel as their Lord yourself. Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord.
That poor little
girl.
Oh, feel that cold air. Oh, thank God for AC.
I want to go up here.
Faith. We hear that word a lot. But faith is not just a word, my brothers and sisters. Oh, no. What is faith? Remember Luke 18:27. What is impossible for man is possible for God. With that righteous faith comes the salvation of your souls. Can you cross that invisible bridge to salvation? Do you want your soul to be saved, brothers and sisters? Oh, yes. You are not like all these sinners out there. So I never asked the Lord for a sign. Then, He gave me one. He spoke to me and told me that I was doing right. And to reward our great faith, the Lord sent me the ultimate gift, an angel. A child graced with the power of God.
Yep.
The miracle we have all been praying for, waiting for. Can I get a hallelujah? Do you have faith in His power? Do you have faith in me? Then please welcome our newest member. And our latest miracle, the angel Daniel.
My God, they shaved his hair.
Here is Daniel, the prophet who was thrown to the lions by false prophets. But God saved Daniel so he could do his work.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Daniel was brought to me to deliver us, to guide us from the wilderness to our destiny. Now Daniel will reveal the true power of the Lord.
Thank you.
dying in the cross.
Bless you, Dan.
Rise. Get
I can't believe it. Stand.
Oh, God.
Thank you, Dan.
Daniel's been touched by God.
Spread the word. Bear witness to this miracle. Thank you so much for coming. And God bless all of us. Amen.
As our Reverend said, we do appreciate your kind donations. This helps us keep our church and to spread the word of God. Oh yeah, there's only a few tickets left for our picnic raffle next Sunday. Don't miss the child and another miracle. Any questions, please talk to me outside. Bless you for coming today.
And they're just using Daniel to be a miracle from the Jesus Christ, the Lord, the Savior.
Hi.
Oh, hi.
I saw you out in that parking lot earlier.
Yep, that was me.
I like to be here too. We can see the whole room. And it's where a Reverend Mother teaches us classes.
Whoa. You okay? Need some water?
No, sorry. I'm just kind of sick.
Oh, that sucks. Oh, that's too bad.
Hey, what happened to your eye?
Well, that's a long story.
That's okay. My name is Sarah Lee. What's yours?
Aw, you must be Jacob's sister. Did you get that letter from Jacob? Back when he was in California?
Yes. How did you know he was in California?
I was with him. That's how we met.
You are Daniel's brother? Really? He's always talking about you.
Hey, not too loud. Yes. Daniel's brother, but I need some help.
The Reverend Mother says we always have to help our neighbor. What do you need?
What is this place?
This is our home. Our church and community. The Reverend Mother says we are all chosen by God.
Who is this Reverend?
You don't know her? That's our mother, Lisbeth. She was blessed by the hand of God when she was my age. She can't ever sin. The Lord guides her.
What is Daniel doing here?
He's our miracle. And the Lord brought him right to our Reverend Mother. I like him. He's really kind and funny. We play together all the time.
So, can you take me to Daniel?
Oh, yes. He's gonna be so happy when he sees you. He missed you so much for his birthday.
Please don't get me sick.
It would be a complete surprise.
Daniel, you're the living proof of their faith. And mine. I know you understand.
I guess, I mean, Sean?
Oh, my.
Sean! He came back! I knew it!
You've grown up, and I know.
Do I look older? What? What happened to your eye?
Don't worry. It's okay.
Did that happen at the farm? Because of me? I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
Forget it. It wasn't your fault. I should have... It's okay.
Does it hurt?
No. Not as much as your haircut.
Shut up. It's different. I kinda like... Sean, I didn't want to leave you there. Nothing I could do. I was so scared. I even thought you were dead. And...
It's okay. We're together now.
Yes. So, are you gonna stay with us now? Huh?
We still need to go to Puerto Lobos.
But... We don't need to. We have a new home now. Look!
One step at a time, Din. Give Sean a chance to process this. I'm sure this is all so overwhelming. By the way, my name is Lisbeth Fisher. We all prayed for your safe return. Sean, you must be a believer now in our Lord, too.
Kinda.
Daniel told me you had faith. That's how you got here. But first, I need Sarah Lee and Daniel to grab the medicine kit. We have to take care of our new guest. This is a place of healing.
Aww. Let's do it later. I want to talk to him now.
Daniel? Now.
Okay, Reverend Mother.
Let's go, Daniel.
Whoa, whoa. Hold on.
Well, Sean, it's a pleasure to meet you. This is a real blessing today. You were away from Daniel for quite a while.
I was in a coma.
Of course. I wasn't judging you. So what is your plan, Sean? This is a blessed family, and it would be good for Daniel to have you by his side. You should know that the Lord has big plans for him.
I'm leaving here. With Daniel.
Yes. Yes, I know about this reckless journey.
I'm his family.
Two young boys are not a family. Mark 3:25. If a house is divided against itself, that house cannot stand.
Daniel sounds more like a prisoner than a guest.
It saddens me that you see things that way. After everything I've done for him, I know why you're spared, Sean. That's because your heart's full of sins. You've led your brother into killing one of God's innocent creatures, disrupting nature's balance. This is a terrible sin, and until you make penance for it, I can't accept you here.
What? Are you serious?
I'm sorry, my son.
I'm not your son. And Daniel isn't gonna be your golden cow. Daniel! Come on!
Why don't we ask him what he wants to do?
Do not touch me!
What the fuck?
What did you do?
Nothing.
Enough. You spilled blood. In the Lord's
Sean! What happened?
Your brother came in here, impure and acting like a criminal. But he can be saved, Daniel.
Oh my God.
She's right. I will pray for you. Ben, when you're ready, we can.
She's trying to manipulate you.
Let me lead you to the one true light that never goes out. I want to be your friend.
You're crazy! Let's get out of here, Dan.
I want to stay. Just stay.
There's your answer, Sean.
We're together again. So we can go, right?
Come on.
Get off me, dude. What? Daniel! Let me go, asshole! Daniel! They're not your family!
Stop it.
You just need to have faith. We'll be waiting.
Daniel!
It's okay, Sean!
Daniel!
There you go. Satisfied? Now don't you ever come back! Come on, kid. Don't make me do this. You're not gonna win.
Daniel! Daniel!
You're pissing me off. This is private property. I have a legal right to stop any intruders like you.
I just want my brother.
But he doesn't want you. He was brought here. This is where he stayed. Next time, I will not hesitate to use this. Get out of here.
Daniel, hey! Daniel?
Sean?
Who are you?
You won't get him back like this.
That's his mom? Hey, mother. I'm so happy to see each other.
You know, Sean, sooner or later, we're gonna have to talk.
Hello?
Where are we even going?
I already have a hotel room. You're gonna need to rest and clean that dressing.
I'm taking a shower. Oh yeah. Nobody come in here. I'm taking a shower. I'm the naked.
Man. Didn't clean the pain away, but...
At least it felt good.
Damn. You look bad. Gotta change that dressing soon. Wonder how long Karen has been here. Did she see one of Danny?
There's nothing.
I really should finish reading this someday.
Holy, 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 holy.
Huh. This isn't her tablet. Yay, technology.
Holy technology.
Reverend Mother doesn't look too humble. Looks like a Roach Motel.
A Roach Motel.
Nobody will find me there.
What's a roach?
Be right back. We'll find out.
She looked you once. You think that she's gonna leave you again?
Karen was always into low-tech. I even think it's the one she had back then.
Back in my days, I had the same phone as I do today.
We've come a long, long way, buddy. This thing is killing my back. I got bruises on my bruises.
Ow, that hurts. Lovely baby, Buddha Buddha. Alright, what's this?
This country is just way too big. So Karen did check it out. Wonder if she saw Daniel in action. Kinda pretty. Wonder if she made it. I know I shouldn't peek, but... whatever. Glad to know she learned the lesson. Karen did her own road trip to get here. Damn. Karen does like to capture the world around her. Karen said she left me Jacob's number somewhere. Karen was always into low tech. I even think it's the one she had back then.
I don't want to look at that again. Is she put in here somewhere?
Karen seems to be on the move quite often.
Where in the heck's the phone number?
only took Supermom 8 years to get
it. Oh, it's
shit.
Right there. Took me 500 years to find that phone number.
Jacob, it's me, Sean. I know. I'm not far. In a motel.
Listen, I can't talk right now.
Wait! Daniel, how's he doing?
Tomorrow afternoon, there's a junction just above him. There's a wild rice ranch over there. I'll be there.
He couldn't really talk. All this is so messed up.
Christians can't talk when they're at church. At that church.
Let's just rest
at Havenport.
If she comes back.
I spin right round, baby, right round. Pass out.
Come here.
Hey, sorry it took so long. The fucking store was packed.
What, your poor fatty?
How are you feeling? Nothing broken? Altar boys don't fight fair?
Yeah. I'm okay.
Double cheese, no onion. Right?
That'll do.
Got you some gauze and antibacterial stuff for your eye. Hey, don't wolf that down. Or at least take a breath.
I am a wolf!
Like you care.
Sean, I do.
Come on, Karen. Don't act all hurt. It's too late. Where were you when I broke my leg when I was 13? Not with me. When Daniel got a bad flu a couple of years ago, you didn't sleep next to him every night. Where were you? Where were you?
Fair enough. So let's talk, because we do have to get your brother out of a cult.
I'm listening.
How did you two survive alone on the road for that long?
We almost didn't. We just kept moving.
And nobody helped you along the way?
You know I don't have to answer your questions, right?
You're right. So tell me what you want from me, Sean.
Nothing, Karen. I mean, what do you want from me? A fucking hug?
Hey, I just want you to know what I did and why, if you care. So ask me anything.
All right. Why did you bail on us?
I wasn't meant to be a wife or a mother. I thought I was supposed to. I tried to pretend for many years. I wasn't happy, and the urge to leave just became unbearable. I had no other choice.
Are you serious? You chose this life. You fell in love. You made your own choices, right?
Making your own choices doesn't mean you can never fool yourself, Sean. After I had Daniel, you were about 8, and Esteban's garage was getting busy. There was so much going on around me, somehow I just felt that my own life was just slipping away. I felt like an empty shell. Sean, it was the hardest decision I ever made.
I knew I might never see you all again. But I took that responsibility.
Did Dad know about all of this?
I was honest with your father. We did family therapy, but it wasn't about him. It was me.
He was heartbroken for months after you left. Years.
I was too. I was in love with your father. He was the best person I ever met.
But just not enough for you.
Something was missing from the equation, yeah. I was.
So what exactly are you doing in Nevada? You live around here?
No. I'm way out in Arizona. Sean, I told you. Your friend Jacob broke my P.O. box and said Daniel was in trouble. That's it.
Arizona? Holy shit. It's just lizards and rocks.
Guess I found something there. New York didn't really do me good, so...
Yeah, okay. I think I've heard enough.
I didn't have a choice, Sean. We only have one life. And I didn't want mine to be spent in regrets. For years, I fooled myself. Thinking I'd find satisfaction into what society expected me to be. And that was my mistake. I hope someday you can understand that. But I never stopped caring about you. For what it's worth, I am sorry for hurting you and Daniel and Esteban.
I know you are, Karen. It still doesn't change the way I feel.
Of course not. I know I can't change the past, Sean.
I don't think you would. I need some air.
Sean, whatever you want to say to me, this is the time. Let's just get it all out in the open. See what happens.
So, did you ever actually miss us? Or Dad?
Of course, Sean. I do miss your father. He had such a big heart. He could brighten up a rainy day with things like his superpower. But above all, I miss watching you grow up. See how you saw the world. I miss sharing these moments with you, Sean.
We used to do so much stuff. Like when you taught me to ride because Dad sucked. Or when we went camping near Vancouver. Just me and you.
You always loved night skies.
I did stargaze a lot when I was in California.
Trust me, the further south you go, the better it gets.
What did you do when you left? Where did you go?
I pursued some dreams and failed. Learned the lessons. I guess all this time I tried to find out what really matters to
me. Which doesn't involve a husband and two kids.
It does to a lot of people. And I totally respect that. Just not to me. I wasn't good at making plans, which is what most of modern life is about, right? School, job, marriage. As my mom and dad, they wanted me to follow their rules, their faith. I tried, but I wanted to find my own way, with no security blanket. Family, religion, social norms. It's just all about security, after all. But it all just looked like a sweet golden jail to me. I tried to escape that.
You just sound immature, like a kid running away from home.
You're right. I do. But I think people should know who they are. Not fake it for anybody.
I mean, I get you wanted to leave and stuff, okay? But why would you ghost us like that? Not even a fucking birthday card.
I thought if I vanished, you would all move on. But I wanted to contact you guys so many times. I almost did.
But you wanted a clean break from us.
I didn't want to be a part-time, pissed-off mother. Not fair to any of you. I left when Daniel was still very young, so he wouldn't remember me.
Cool plan, Mom. You hurt Daniel way worse. He thought you took off because of him.
I know. I hope I can make it up to you, Daniel, someday. I could start by getting his ass out of that church. Cult. Whatever.
Whatever. You sound so careless. It's like you can't even realize how much pain you've caused.
I do care. That's why I'm here. To help you and your brother. If I didn't step up to help him now, I couldn't live with myself. Esteban hated it as well. He didn't want me to die or early death. Fuck. Life can be so cynical sometimes.
I remember he would smoke sometimes. Long ago.
We didn't fight much. But when we did, I would go out on the porch and light up so I could calm down. Esteban would come over and ask for a drag. I would just look up at the sky, watch the stars, or the planes. I do miss that.
I used to do the same with my best friend, Mike. Sitting on the porch, just letting time go.
That's when you know someone's good to you. When you can just sit together, shut the hell up, and watch the universe do its own thing.
should go back inside. I gotta change this dressing.
Okay. Let's go.
Now it's the mother and son bonding time.
Sean, I know I can't change the past. Or what I did. But this is about helping your brother. You gotta trust me this one time.
I know. It's still hard. But yes, we have to be a team to rescue Daniel.
We can do it.
Okay. How?
We need to get in touch with this Jacob. He obviously knows a lot more than us about the church.
Well, I called him when we were out. We can meet with him tomorrow.
Okay, good. I also got these, just in case.
Okay. Better take care of the eye.
So, do you need any help with that?
Yes. Thanks.
So, you feel like telling me the story here?
When we have time.
Gotcha.
Look, she's crying because she never got to do this whenever they were younger. Well, whenever he was younger. And she missed out on everything.
Here, try this on.
I am Captain Diaz.
Great.
Thank you, Kira.
Big day tomorrow, so you should get some rest.
Yeah. I'm ready to get Daniel.